on the property likely experience only Category 1 or Category 2 conditions.
This is contrary to the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, who are trying to claim that Katrina was a
1 in 496 probability of occurrence.
The Army Corps generals came out in their green suits and immediately said that
that was a big storm.
The reason they're doing that is to cover their behind.
That's a clip from the documentary The Big Uneasy, a film that explores the real reason New Orleans flooded after Hurricane Katrina and also the ongoing revival of a great American city. We're joined now by the director of that film, actor and comedian Harry Shearer. How great to see you. Welcome back.
See you. Thank you.
So, conventional wisdom, Hurricane Katrina and what happened afterward in New Orleans, natural disaster. Mm-hmm. You say nonsense.
Look, I'm a comedian. I work in the show business world. What I say doesn't matter, but what I did in this film was focus the camera on three people who do know what they're talking about, the leaders of two independent investigations into the flooding, and a whistleblower from inside the Corps of Engineers. The two leaders of the investigations lasted months, involved dozens and dozens of highly skilled and eminent people, uniformly concluded that this was not a natural disaster. This was, in the words of the co-leader of the Berkeley investigation, the greatest man-made engineering catastrophe since Chernobyl. Now, this was before Fukushima, but that's pretty big nonetheless. They placed the responsibility squarely at the feet of the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. Over 4.5 decades under administrations of both political parties, this is not a partisan story, which I think is possibly why it hasn't gotten as much oxygen as it might have, is because people can't sit across the table and say, it's your fault. No, it's your fault. Everybody's got an oar in this water.
In the film, there's a mention of a 1988 report, among many other things, where essentially people waving their arms, screaming, saying, these levees will not hold.
People inside the Corps of Engineers wrote this report.
Right.
And the Corps of Engineers ignored it.
So that raises the question, why were these reports ignored over 4 decades, did you say? Were they incompetent? Were they corrupt? Were they underfunded? What was the problem?
Well, if you ask any government agency, including the Corps of Engineers, they'll always say, more money, please. It was not money that made them make some of the decisions they made. It was not money that made them, for example, in the very early days when Congress in 1966 said to the Corps, build a system that will protect New Orleans from the maximum probable hurricane, Congress's words. And the Corps immediately redefines that as a standard project hurricane, and they throw out of that model all of the recent most severe hurricanes as improbable outliers. That wasn't Congress with budget strings saying you must do that. That's the Corps' own choice. Why? We don't go into mind reading in the film. We just tell what happened and leave the viewer to make a decision. But if I had to speculate, I'd say that in 1927, the Corps was given blanket immunity by Congress from civil liability on any flood control work. And if you tell people in any kind of organization, private or public, big or small, there's no penalty for failure, you're going to get more failure.
Let me ask Gary. When you talk about how prepared it was for a hurricane, obviously we hear 2, 3, 4, 5. Did they make a decision, the Corps of Engineers, and did they say, look, this thing will handle a Category 4 hurricane, or this will handle a Category 5 hurricane, or it will only handle a 3?
They said this will handle a 3, but in fact, as you saw Max Mayfield at the beginning of that clip, when Katrina bypassed New Orleans, it was a maximum, a strong 1 or a weak 2. The storm surge that hit New Orleans was under the level that the Corps had said would be withstood by its system. As a matter of fact, that's the first thing that led these investigators to make their investigation. They went and looked at the actual evidence on scene days afterwards before it had been cleaned up. The Corps said the water was so high, the surge was so high, it overtopped the walls. Uh-huh. And Dr. Van Heerden, whom you saw in that clip, went and said, water leaves a mark. The high water mark is nowhere near the top of the wall. This did not overtop the levees. Mm-hmm. This did not overtop the walls.
Did the investigation, they look back, obviously, did they also look forward? I mean, did they make projections about what would happen, you know, if a storm of that size or larger hits? Is it forward-looking in?
Those investigations were forensic. They were doing what nobody else did, which was look back and affix responsibility. There is a third person in the film who is a whistleblower from inside the Corps working on the new multi-billion dollar system which we've just constructed under the last two administrations, and she was responsible for supervising the testing and installation of pumps that are at the heart of the new system. And she says they never passed their tests, even when the testing standards were sequentially lowered over and over again. They were installed by the Corps anyway, and they will not work during a storm surge event. And those are the pumps we have in New Orleans right now. And that's in the film. The update, very coincidentally to the fact that the film is coming out on DVD and VOD and all these other digital platforms right now, but 2 weeks ago, the GAO looked at the contract the Corps let for the new pumps to replace those defective pumps, said, A, the Corps had given the contract to a crony, a former official of the Corps in New Orleans, and B, the amount of time the Corps spent evaluating that bidder's technical ability to build pumps that would work was less than 5 minutes. Now, that's less than the O.J. jury spent, you say, just for perspective.
You say crony like it's a bad thing.
I do,
leave
yes.
that aside for a minute.
It's a loaded word.
You're a part-time resident of that city.
Yes,
that obviously animates you to some extent. But why are you so passionate about this and telling this story?
Well, because it's not just New Orleans. You know, Dallas was told a couple of years ago, hey, those levees that are along the Trinity River that run through downtown Dallas, they're built on sand. Sacramento has a bullseye on its back. This is all over the country. The Corps, and it's not just levees, and it's not just flood control. The Corps are the people who are doing these possibly very damaging kinds of dredging projects, like on the Delaware River in Savannah. They're a very controversial agency, but they fly under the radar because every congressional district has a Corps project. That's the way the system works. Michael Grunwald, who's a former journalist at the Washington Post, wrote a five-part series on the Corps, and it really does a good job
now
of explaining.
My colleague at Time now.
Now, yeah, and explains this system by which the Corps works. There, Dr. Robert Bee, who's the leader of the Berkeley investigation, was in the Corps, and he says very clearly, it's no longer the Corps of Engineers. They hollowed out to a great extent in the 80s. They're now the Corps of Contract Administrators, and their job is to, you know, supervise contracting on projects they don't understand because they're not engineers anymore.
Let me ask you a question about the big thing that all of us saw was all those people at the New Orleans Superdome down there sitting there day after day and the whole country screaming. I think that's the reason this country was so focused on it, was what appeared to be the human tragedy of 15,000 people. Could they have done that? I mean, it seems to me, look, when you see what happened at Dunkirk, they got 350,000 troops off under German fire in 5 days. What went wrong there that they couldn't get those people off of it?
Well, I don't deal with the aftermath in the film. I deal with the cause of the disaster.
Right.
But let me tell you, if you've read the book Zaytun by Dave Eggers, which is a nonfiction book about the experience of one man in New Orleans, it reveals a fact hitherto unknown either to me or I think most of the rest of us, which is while nobody could bring food and water down there, somebody managed to build a secret prison in the Greyhound bus parking lot within 2 days. Because that's where this man was kept incommunicado for a month, because he happened to be Syrian American and people didn't like the way he looked. But to your larger point, you saw the 15,000 people in the convention center and the Superdome. What you didn't see was the thousands of white folks on their roofs without food and water for 4 days, 10 miles east of there in St. Bernard Parish, because TV didn't go there. And so this event was marginalized as a racial or a class story when it affected everybody. It flooded 80% of a metropolitan area. It was white folks, black folks, poor folks, middle class folks, Asians, Latinos. I think the media coverage of this story marginalized it. It took the usness out of this event.
Given our current economic and political climate,
it's a good one.
It doesn't bode well, I wouldn't think, for infrastructure like what you're talking about here.
We just had $8 to $15 billion invested on this system that has at the heart of it defective pumps. It's not a money issue.
So what do you need to change?
I think somebody needs to change the culture of the United States Army Corps of Engineers. I think that's what everybody in this film who studied the matter concludes. And it starts with, you know, the whistleblower in this film reported on these pumps through the channels, went to the U.S. Office of Special Counsel, which handles whistleblower complaints. A letter from them summarizing the problems was placed on the desks of the chairman of the Armed Services Committees of both houses and of the President of the United States in June of 2009. where it has sat, apparently unread since then.
We should point out to people there's nothing conspiratorial or particularly romantic about this film in any way. It's just a well-argued case. The movie is The Big Easy.
The Big Uneasy,
excuse me, available nationwide now on video on demand. You can check it out through your cable system or on web portals, including iTunes and Xbox, also on DVD through Amazon, The Big Uneasy. Harry, thanks so much for bringing us this story.
Thank you. And TheBigUneasy.com has all that information.
TheBigUneasy.com.
Thanks.
And you can see more.